Hey everyone, Docwell here, and welcome to another video. Today we're going to be looking at settings, options, hotkeys, all of those kinds of things, just for new players or players that are lower MMR, just to see what I use, and just give you a brief overview for anybody, you know, that's just starting out or anything like that, to see, you know, what you should do, the most optimal way to set things up. Obviously, you know, there's some debate depending on the hotkeys, and everyone's hotkeys are a little bit different, but I'm just going to show you what I use so you can copy that. It's pretty straightforward, pretty easy, pretty simple. So before we jump into the options and the hotkeys, I'm actually just going to spend a minute or so on the social tab. And you can see I have no incoming chat selected. Sometimes I have friendly players and teammates selected. These are the two options I think you should have selected. Basically, this means you want to communicate with your team. But a lot of times, you know, this is honestly just a better option because you don't want to hear what your team has to say. Even at my level, a lot of times what people have to say is often just trash. Now, sometimes you have good people on your team that communicate well, but that doesn't usually happen. So if you're not going to have, you know, no incoming chat, then you want to have this on. I would say never have all players because you never really want to talk to the enemy team because they're just going to tilt you. They're just going to say things that are going to try to probably, you know, tilt you, make you play bad, that kind of stuff. Maybe put this on if you want to, you know, talk trash at the very end of the game. But that's pretty much the chat social tab there. And I think that's actually important to know how to utilize this in order to gain MMR and get better and also not be crazy when you're playing Dota. So that's important. And then the other thing, the last thing on the social tab is just expose public match data. This is so that Dota buff and other things can, you know, see your stats, see your game, all that kind of stuff. So have that selected if you want that to be the case. So that's the social tab. Now we're going to move to options. So I'm just briefly going to go over the options that are probably the most important. Auto attack, not a big deal. Auto select summon units is a big deal. I have this selected. It's pretty good for like Manta and other things because as soon as you know, summon the Manta, press Manta, whatever it is, you control those units. So you can, like, you know, you jump in with Anti-Mage and then you press Manta. Well, now you're controlling all that. You don't have to push another button. You just are automatically controlling the Manta units. So you're all attacking the same target because you're right-clicking, all those kinds of things. Makes everything easier. The only thing I would say with this is that you probably don't want this selected with something like PL because it'll auto-select all of the illusions that are generated by PL and it can be very, very annoying. Sometimes you actually like can't even select just your hero because the other illusions are, you know, being created at the time that you're trying to select your hero. So you should probably take this off if you're going to play PL. It's one of the only settings that you will like turn on and off depending on the hero. So that's auto-select summon units. This double tap and smart double tap, all that stuff, it just helps so that you can double tap abilities and double tap items. There's other options in here that allow you to double tap things to self-cast them. It's pretty useful. I would say you should probably use that. And then unified orders with the control, pretty straightforward. And then the next one that's important is teleport requires hold stop. For any new player or player that's having trouble, you know, with their teleport scrolls, they keep screwing it up, you need to have this selected. It's a pretty good option because what'll happen a lot of times is, you know, you are teleporting to a lane after you spawned or something like that, and you have to time it perfectly to, you know, when to move, otherwise you're going to cancel your TP. Well, this, you don't have to worry about that. You just TP to the mid lane or something like that. You spam your right click to move, and it'll just automatically move as soon as the TP is done because you actually have to press hold or stop in order to cancel it. So it just makes, you know, it pretty much prevents you from ever screwing up TPs ever again. So it's pretty good to have that selected. And if you play something like Enigma with Black Hole or Witch Doctor with his alt, you could probably also have channel abilities require hold stop. So anything that's channeled, you don't accidentally press it and then right click or something to screw that up. I don't play those heroes all that often. I have played them occasionally, but I don't play them enough that I would really need this. And usually when I do, I'm pretty good at not canceling those abilities. But that's just something else that you could use if you want to. I personally don't, but it's not a big deal if you do. This next one is probably the most controversial thing that I have selected. It's right click to force attack. Basically, what this does is it makes it so that when you are going to deny creeps, you don't have to click the A button or the attack button, whatever, you know, hotkey that is for you, and then hit the creep. So it just makes it so that you can right click to last hit, you can right click to deny. It just makes everything a right click. You don't have to worry about hitting attack. Now, I do hit attack sometimes. It doesn't really matter, but the point being is that I think it just simplifies everything. Now, it does make your character or your hero act in weird ways. If you click on a allied creep or hero that you can't actually attack, it'll make you auto attack, and sometimes you'll be running away and then it'll kind of run into the enemy. I have, you know, gotten really used to this setting, so I don't really do that anymore. I understand when that's going to happen, so I, you know, understand not to do that. But it's something that you do have to get used to, and it's probably not an optimal setting that a lot of higher level, like 10K players use. But I think you can get to my level, you can get pretty high using this, and I bet there are some people that are high MMR that do use this. So it's pretty controversial, I think, but I would say it's really, really good for new players because it just makes everything simpler, especially laning. It makes laning so much easier. So that's right-click to force attack. I would suggest using it, but you don't necessarily have to if you don't want to. Next, we're going to move on to the camera. And the camera has a couple settings that are important. Obviously, you want edge pan on so you can, you know, click the edge of the screen to move about. I would say that if you don't use camera grip, you should use that. This just says reverse camera grip. It's not a big deal, but I will talk about camera grip. You do want to have your middle mouse button be camera grip, and I think that will really help new players, you know, control the camera in a much better way, and it'll make you have better camera movements and just better, you know, map understanding and awareness and those kinds of things, because you'll be able to, you know, center your camera on your hero and what you're doing a lot easier. I know I've seen some replays where people have trouble with the camera, so having edge pan and camera grip on is important. Obviously, you don't want to reverse it unless, you know, you want to or things like that, but that is important. And then along with having that middle mouse button, the scroll wheel clicking in to be the camera grip, you also want to have this selected, which is disabling camera zoom, just in case you hit that scroll wheel or you scroll it. Even if you don't have the middle mouse button as your camera grip, it just makes it annoying when it zooms in. Just don't have that. There's no point in having that in the actual game. So I would have that selected. And then the last thing here is center camera on hero respawn. You want to have this deselected. That way, when you are TPing to a tower or something like that after you're dead, or like when you're dead, you're just waiting to TP. Let's say you're dying and you're going to TP, or you're dead and you're going to TP mid. While you're kind of looking at mid, waiting to TP, well then as soon as you spawn, the camera goes back to base, and then you click TP and you click in a spot, it's going to screw you up, and sometimes you'll end up TPing just into base from base. So you pretty much just want to have this deselected. There's absolutely no reason to have this. Plus, later on I'll show you a setting that you should have a setting where you can double click a certain hotkey to just center on your hero. So you'll just use that instead of this. So I would have this deselected. So that's mainly the camera things. And next, we're going to look at the minimap. I think my minimap is probably the best way to have your minimap set up, and I'll explain it in a second. So basically, these two are, if you have these deselected, it's pretty much default. I also have the simple background. If you don't have simple background selected, it's like this. I just have it so it makes it easier to see. But basically, I have these two settings enabled because when you have a normal minimap, it just shows all the colors and directions, and then when you hold Alt, it shows the names. Well, first, I click use alt to show hero icons, so then when you hold alt, you see the hero icons instead, and then I have invert alt toggle, so that actually you see the hero icons by default, and then you can hold alt and you can see the direction and the colors. This just makes it so much easier, so you don't have to memorize colors and who's what color. You can just see the icon on the minimap for a split second, you know exactly who it is, where they are, all that kind of stuff. You don't have to think more, you don't have to memorize the colors or look at the top of the screen to say who's what color and all of that kind of stuff. And if you do want to see a direction, you can just hold alt and then you'll see that. But I think this is the best way to have it so that you can just get that information as quick as possible and you don't have to think too hard about anything. You also don't have to read. If you have it like this, you have to kind of like read the name. Now that might take a split second, but seconds like that are really important, and you just want to be able to like look at the minimap. You just see with the picture. It's very, very simple. I think it's the best way to have it. And then I also increase the size a little bit. This is the default. It's just kind of small. Putting it up to 115 or 120 or something like that just makes it a little bit bigger so you can see it a little easier out of the corner of your eye. So I think that's the best map settings. I would have everybody use that. You can choose to have the simple on or not. It's up to you. But I just like it because it makes it easier to see. So that is my minimap. And next we'll go to interface. All of these settings are pretty simple. Basically, just holding Alt shows you spawn boxes and a tower attack range and all of that kind of stuff. It's really, really helpful. I would have all of these selected. Next, we have, you should disable, enable, simple shop. I don't even know why they have this. I don't think it's very good, even for new players, because it just kind of dumbs down the game in a way that's not really useful. Doesn't allow you to like learn as much as you should. So just disable this. If you're brand new, this is why the shop is really weird. Just disable this. And then the rest of the things in here are just pretty much not that important, just kind of personal preference. So you can select or deselect whatever you want there. So those are the main options. Now we're going to go to advanced options here. So with summon unit auto attack, I just have always. That way, if I do summon something, it'll just automatically auto attack. I don't have to like give it another order, but it's up to you if you play more micro heroes. I don't play a ton of micro heroes, so I kind of keep that way. These ones, not super important. I will say quick cast on key down is kind of important. That means whenever you're trying to quick cast something, which we'll talk about a little bit later, it means that you don't have to put the key down and then lift the key up to have that ability or item enabled. It just happens as soon as you press the key. So I would have that selected. These other ones are not super important that I think. I mean, I think auto repeat right mouse is something you could use. It might be important so you don't have to keep clicking right mouse. You can just hold it in. You can use that if you want. The rest I don't think are all that important. And then the last ones here, just like basically if you're doing something else while Dota's finding a match or whatever, it'll just bring Dota to the front when you find a match and all those things. So that is kind of important to have selected. Now we go to the camera, and there's something important here, which is enable screen shake. You want to have this deselected because something like Earthshaker with a lot of stuns and those kinds of things will actually shake the screen, and it'll make it harder to see what's going on if you have this selected. So you should deselect this for just basic competitive reasons, or just, you know, to be able to see what's going on in the game more. This kind of adds obviously a stylized thing, but you don't really need it. It's not really helpful. It's actually like detrimental to you when you're actually playing the game. So you want to deselect that. And then the last thing here, we have a bunch of other options that are kind of just miscellaneous, not the biggest of deals. I will say that this one, the strict solo queue matchmaking, is important to point out because this is what allows you to basically get matched up with only other solo queue people, especially when you're playing ranked. You don't want to be matched up against parties because that'll have like boosters, smurfs, those kinds of things, bursters, I guess, in parties and things. It's just more likely. Now, this will obviously decrease your queue or increase your queue time, but it shouldn't be that big of a deal unless you're like really low behavior score. So I would usually have this selected, and I usually do that, but it's up to you, whatever you want. If you like matching with other parties and you think it helps, then you can do that too. So those are the options that I have. I think they're pretty good. Most of them are kind of up to you, but I do believe there are a few that are important, like enable screen shake, like these camera zoom and things like that. This right click to force attack, I think, might be important. Auto select summon units is kind of important. And then this minimap, I think, is the most important. Having this minimap like this, I think, is just the most efficient setup. So those are my options, and I hope that helps you there. Next, we are going to go to the hotkeys. And these hotkeys are pretty simple setup. I don't have like anything too complicated. In fact, I probably should have some more hotkeys, but I just don't because I don't play Micro Heroes all that often. But before we get into everything, I'm just going to go to advanced, because what you need to do before you do anything else is enable advanced quickcast / autocast hotkeys. Because once you enable that, it makes you able to customize this a little bit more than you otherwise would be, because usually it just kind of allows you to have everything on quickcast or everything off of quickcast, which is not what you want. So you want to enable that, and then you want to put unit specific hotkeys on. That way, something like AM, for instance, I have just a normal cast for all visibilities, and then quickcast I have blink on quickcast, because that way I can just, you know, put my mouse in a direction and then just click the W button and he'll just automatically blink. I don't have to push W and then left click on an area. I'll just click W and he'll blink to wherever my mouse is or in that direction. So I usually use that with blink and other things like that, some other things for quick cast. But then some heroes may have an ability that you want to have normal cast because you want to aim it or whatever, and then quick cast for some other thing. So it just depends. So that's why you want to have unit specific hotkeys. Like this Mana Void, I want to very specifically target who I want to Mana Void. I don't want to just, you know, automatically Mana Void the person that my mouse is hovering over. So that's why it's a pretty good example with AM here. So that's unit-specific hotkeys. And if you don't know the difference between quick cast and cast, it's basically cast. You click it, and then you have to like left click or use it. Quick cast, it just automatically happens wherever your mouse is when you click the button. So it's pretty simple and straightforward. And the same thing applies to items. Now, these are my item hotkeys. We'll simply go over these quickly. I have V for my teleport scroll, and you're going to want your teleport scroll on cast, not quick cast. And this is because you want to be able to double click your TP scroll, because that'll automatically take you back to base. Otherwise, if you have it on quick cast, it'll teleport you to the closest place that you can teleport that's close to your mouse. You don't want that. You just want to be able to double click your TP scroll to instantly TP back to base. It's just something that's very, very quick, and it makes it really, really easy. So like on Storm Spirit, you zip, you double click your TP scroll, and you'll start TPing while you're zipping. So it's important to have that on cast. I also have my neutral item on cast as 4. That's just because I sometimes want to aim different neutral items. Just depends. So I have that on 4 because it just varies what's in there. And then my other cast, normal cast items are just T, B, and G. So T is usually an item that I use a lot, or something like Manta, other things like that, Quelling Blade, other stuff like that. I usually have on T, maybe Abyssal Blade, something that I use a lot. B is something I don't really use at all. you know, it's just not really useful. Maybe it's an item that doesn't even have an active or something like that. I'll just put that in B. And then G is reserved for the things that are kind of close so I can hit them pretty easily. It's not like I'm going to fat finger them, but it's something I don't want to click a lot because it's a little bit, it's kind of like a little bit farther away than, you know, T or 5 or 4, those kinds of things. So I usually put BKB on there if I'm a core, and I usually put wards on there if I'm a support. So that's just like how I use that. And also with the wards and other things like that, you want to aim them. So you want them to be on a cast hotkey. So those are my cast hotkeys, and then we'll move to the quick cast hotkeys. I have mouse 4, 5, and space. Space I usually have for blink dagger, and that way I don't have to, you know, click it and then click in a place. I just click wherever my mouse is, and I'll blink right there. And then 4 or 5 or other things like that where I just want to instantly use them and things like that. I actually have my treads a lot of times or boots on one of these hotkeys. Not that it's a big deal. It doesn't need to be quick cast, but I just usually have that on there, and I'll have just other things that I want to quick cast or that don't really need to be quick cast on these abilities, because quick cast, I have 3 and 3, but there's not as many things that you want to quick cast. So sometimes I just put stuff on there that are just like active, like treads or like phase boots or other things like that. When I'm a support, I usually put like, I usually put force staff on T. I may put like, Glimmer Cape or other things on these auto cast or quick cast things like that. So it just depends on what items I'm buying and when and all that kind of stuff. So those are my hotkeys for items. Pretty straightforward. I think they're all pretty good. Space is a good one. And all of these, as you can kind of tell, are all right around my pointer finger, which is good because you're not using alt all that much. So you kind of use your pointer finger for the, you know, for your item, for your neutral tier item. For all of these, I use my pointer finger, and then this is on my mouse, and then this is my thumb, and then that's my pointer finger as well. So it's all pointer finger stuff, pretty straightforward. So those are my basic hotkeys, and now we're just going to get into some other stuff that is just like hotkey generalized things. The first one that's important is I have tab as select hero. You can have tab, a lot of people have tab as like next unit if you do a lot of micro heroes, but I don't play a lot of micro heroes. It's not really my thing. So I just have tab as select hero. That way I can always select my hero. Or if you double click tab, I use my pinky for that. Then I will, it will auto center the camera on my hero. So it's pretty important. It's right there and I can easily get that. I don't have a select all controlled units. I do have that option that you probably saw where I can hold down control and order units. So I probably should have something for that, but I just don't right now because I don't have, I don't play a lot of micro heroes. You see, I have groups. Usually I have like a group one is like all my units, and then group two is just like my units, but not me. That's usually how I play micro heroes. It's pretty straightforward, pretty simple. I could have one as select all controlled units. I could do that too. It's just, I give myself an option to customize my control groups here. So I'll have like, yeah, like one being all the units and then two being all the units except for my hero. Something simple as that. I don't really get too complicated into the micro heroes because I don't play a lot of them. The next is I just have A as the attack move or the force attack. That's pretty much simple there. I have hold position as J because I really don't use hold position as much. And I want my chat wheels to be closer to my pointer finger so they're easy to access. So I actually changed hold position to H, or hero chat wheel to H and hold position to J. I don't really use hold position all that often. So those are pretty much my hotkeys here. You can see my chat one's pretty simple. Camera grip is mouse 3, like I said. Scoreboard is the little tilde, I think that's what it's called, and pause is F9, which is default. So those are the basic hotkeys, and now these are the shop hotkeys. So for me, shop hotkeys are F1 to select the courier, and then you have all the normal hotkeys, Q, W, E, R. I think W is secret shop, E is go home, go to base. But then I have F2 as deliver items, and then I have, I think down here, yeah, F3 is open the shop. So that's courier hotkeys, and then F3 is open the shop. So I use all the F keys for my shop and courier related stuff. And then Z is just purchase quick buy. It's a little bit out of the way, but it's pretty simple to purchase my quick buy then. So anything I put in this quick buy down here, I will just purchase. I don't really use the sticky that much. As we see, there's a sticky, purchase sticky, that's F8. I really don't use that because just TP scrolls in there, and I don't, if I need a TP scroll, I'll just click it. It's not a big deal. And then the last thing for hotkeys is I have learn ability is 3. That's just pretty easy to use that to learn my abilities. And then I have upgrade talent. I don't really use that. I just click it. It's not a big deal. And then I have move as M, and I actually have directional move unassigned. So I play a lot of Slark. It's actually my favorite hero, pretty much. It's my most played hero. And I actually don't use directional move. I think you can get away with just clicking on the ground around the hero. And I very, very rarely miss my pounces, like almost never. I'm pretty good at hitting my pounces like in fog, across trees, across cliffs, all that kind of stuff. I just click like really, really close to my hero, and it's usually pretty good at doing that, and I'm able to really like directionally move wherever I want to move. So I'm pretty good at doing that. It also just helps. I mean, I could get used to using directional move, but I think it just helps that I don't have to think about another hotkey when I want to do something specific. I just like directional move and kind of click a little bit closer. So I think that can help with something like Slark. I don't play a lot of SF though, so if I played SF, maybe I would change my opinion and think I need to use this a little bit more. That way I can, you know, line up a direction and really use it. So it just depends. I would say this is probably another controversial thing that you should probably use if you're going to play Slark or SF. It just will make it easier for you. But there are some people that are high MMR that I know have said they don't use directional move and they just click close to their hero. So it's kind of up to you, but that is another controversial one. The next thing I just have S is stop, and pretty much nothing else assigned. I don't think there's really that big of a deal for any of these. Like, you can just use glyph and scan, like, automatically. You don't really need to press the button. It's not a big deal. And then taunt I have pretty far away. It's important to have this assigned, but not close enough that I'm just, like, hitting it constantly. It's up to you, though. You could have it, like, as 5 or something, or maybe you'll just replace your ultimate button. You'll put taunt as R because it's really that important to you. I don't know. It's up to you, though. The rest of these are kind of just like spectator stuff. I don't have camera positions assigned. I don't have select allies assigned. I don't have more hotkeys for groups or anything like that. It's not really a big deal to me for any of this. And death summary and other things like that, you can just click that when you're dead and all that stuff on the side of the screen there. So not a big deal. And then the last one here, these hotkey options, they're kind of similar to what we talked about before. Quick cast on key down, double tap. Ability to self-cast, all of that kind of stuff. It's just kind of important to have that. Obviously, don't use legacy keys. You don't want this enabled at all. Left click to activate camera grip. You can use this instead of middle mouse button if you want. It's up to you. I would just suggest using middle mouse button. The only thing I will say about the middle mouse button is I've already gone through like 3 mice because I've actually broken the middle mouse button from clicking it so much. So that's the only thing that you may want to consider there. And then obviously we talked about enable advanced quick cast, auto cast hotkeys. So that, my friends, is the hotkey options and basically social tab video for all of you. I hope that made sense. I hope that's an easy overview of my hotkeys and how to use them and what to do. I think it's pretty straightforward. There are some obvious things in here that you want, like to use quick cast and casting. Those are very important. Learning how to select your courier and use that, very important. Having a select hero button is extremely important. I would say even having a level up ability or learn ability button is really important. Opening shop, those kinds of things. Doing everything with a hotkey like that is really, really important to learn. I think mine are fairly straightforward and fairly easy to use, not very complicated. And then other things and options, like I said, the screen shake, the camera zoom, the right click to force attack, and definitely the mini map is super important. I think this is just the best way to have your mini map up and running, so it's easy to have good map awareness by just looking at the mini map really, really quickly. So those are my options. Those are my hotkeys. I hope that helps all of you, you know, have simpler hotkeys, maybe copy some of that stuff if you want. As always, guys, thanks for watching. Like, subscribe, comment, all of those things. Join the Discord if you haven't already. We're doing replay review requests there now. If you want coaching, which I'm just offering now, go to my Patreon. Link is in the description, and you can sign up for coaching. Pretty cheap right now compared to other coaches, so I'm really excited about that. And then, as always, guys, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.